Ends. And by that I mean he cuts them off.
Wake up, Wildcats, and welcome to today's edition of Wildcat News. Today is Wednesday, February 26th, and it's also an A-Day. We got all the news you need to know and more coming right up.
But first, the person we'll be highlighting today for Black History Month is Godfather of Soul, James Brown. Let's find out a little bit more about him.
James Joseph Brown was born May 3, 1933, in Bonneville, South Carolina, to a 16-year-old named Susie and a 22-year-old named Joseph Brown in a small wooden shack. Brown's mother eventually left the family after a contentious and abusive marriage, leaving the young James with his cruel father. James spent long stretches of time on his own, hanging out in the streets and hustling to get by. He managed to stay in school until the sixth grade, and he began singing in talent shows as a young child, first appearing in Augusta's Lennox Theater in 1944, winning the show after singing the ballad So Long. While in Augusta, Brown performed buck dances for change to entertain troops from Camp Gordon at the start of World War II as their convoys traveled over the canal bridge near his aunt's home. He learned to play piano, guitar, and harmonica during this period. James became inspired to become an entertainer after hearing Caledonia by Louis Jordan and his Tempani Five. In October 1958, James released the ballad Try Me, which hit number one on the R&B chart at the beginning of 1959, becoming one of the first of 17 chart-topping R&B hits. From this point on forward, he began to become one of the most influential African-American musicians, having several hits, becoming the godfather of funk, while all at the same time inspiring millions of people with his music. James Joseph Brown passed away December 25th, 2006 at Emory University Hospital, Midtown, Atlanta, Georgia at the age of 73 due to congestive heart failure related to pneumonia. However, his music still lives on and continues to influence billions to this very day.
Now, yesterday, we asked you what species the environmental science class was trying to help this year with their OnLess project. Their correct answer was the monarch butterflies. Congratulations to this week's winners. Now, let's turn it over to Dan, who has what's on our lunch menu.
Hey, guys. Today. Yo, what up? Today for lunch, we have baked macaroni and cheese with breadstick, cheese stick on a torpedo roll, whipped peppers and onions, chicken patty on a bun, cheesy breadsticks with marinara, Big Daddy pizza, and your choice of sides and your choice of milk. Back to you guys in the studio.
Thanks, Mikey.
Now, here are your club activity announcements for this week.
The Performing Musical Arts Club will meet today, after school, in room B-19.
The Multiculture Club will also meet today, after school, in room B-15.
The next Battle of Books meeting is today, after school, in room E-16.
The Debate Club will meet on Thursday, after school, in room E-18.
The next meeting for the Alliance Project will be on Thursday, February 26th, after school, in room E-19.
Attention seniors, don't forget to fill out your general scholarship application. You received an email in early January from Miss Kelly with the Google form attached. The deadline for submission is March 6th.
And seniors, remember to check your email. Miss Kelly has emailed you several scholarship opportunities last week.
Now time for today's segment. Our reporters wanted to know what you would do in the following situation. Let's take a look.
Roll the segment.
Beto. You go home and your family's gone. They never existed. What do you do next?
Probably hang out. Never needed them.
They're just gone. What do you do?
Cry.
Cry?
Probably just like cry.
Probably cry about it or something.
Cry?
Cry, yeah. We got a lot of criers.
Yeah, cry.
You go home and your family's gone. They never existed. What do you do?
Oh my God. Cry.
Celebrate. Well, yeah, at least I have five brothers. Wouldn't you celebrate if they was...
Try to find them?
Well, they never existed. You thought they did the whole time, but they weren't. Like pictures? Like, you thought you had pictures with them, but there was, like, nobody there.
Wake up.
I go find new parents, and I get adopted.
Smart.
I feel really dumb.
Dumb? Yeah. Would you feel insane?
Yeah, I would.
Regain a lot of my hobbies that I used to have.
Like what?
Fishing.
Yeah, I was gonna guess that. Playing basketball.
Snowboarding. I used to do that a lot. But wrestling's, yeah, they've all gotten in the way of that a lot.
Wow. So you back on the grind? Pound it. So, you go home and your family's gone. They never existed. What do you do?
I go into the dark realm and find out where they went.
Spooky.
Throwing a party.
I agree. What would you do about it?
I don't know. Try to figure it out. Like, there's pictures, obviously.
Family never existed. What do you do?
Make one.
I'm calling her so she can come help me.
Word. Oh, but no, like, you took selfies with, like, your family, but there's no one in the pictures anymore. Because you thought they were, but now they're not. You were just hallucinating. You were just a simulation.
Oh, I don't know.
Finally, we would like to wish a very happy birthday to
Victor Miller Ortiz.
Well, that's all the announcements we have for you today. From all of us in the TV studio, thanks for watching.